Hi guys, I'm Kaitlin, co-founder of Mathpix, and today I wanted to just do a quick walkthrough of the new features that we've released on the Snipping tool on Mac, Windows, and Linux. So the big one that we're really excited about is adding PDF conversion into the Snipping tool. Before, it was really only supported on Snip Web, and so this is super convenient for uploading PDFs, processing them. You know, you can do everything on your desktop, or you could pull PDFs into Snip Web, and that workflow is really convenient now too. So I'm just going to drag and drop some PDFs in. That's really the easiest way to do it. You can choose any of the export formats that you could use in Snip Web. They're all here. I'll do .docx. But what's really nice is the tight integration between Snipping Tool and Snip Web. And you'll start to see, you know, these buttons everywhere to open things in Snip Web. So it's going to save it in my downloads as a zip. That's going to give me those documents there. But what's really nice is that these new buttons, the Open in Snip Web buttons, you're going to start seeing them everywhere. But it makes it really convenient to open up a PDF in Snip Web. And there it is. So that's the PDF, one of the PDFs that I just pulled in. Here's the rendering. So it looks really nice. It's really fast. It's really seamless between Snipping Tool and Snip Web. So that's one we're really excited about, is PDF conversion. Another thing that we've added recently is the upload image option. So in the past, you know, it's always been about screenshots, but sometimes you have a lot of images, and going through and taking a screenshot of every single one is kind of painstaking. So we've added this upload image option, and I've just got some images here, actually a bunch of Jordan matrices, because that's something that we've added nice support for recently. So I just open up those images, and it's just going to start processing really fast. So that's really nice, is, you know, saving time, just upload a bunch of images at once and you don't have to go through and screenshot them all. And another thing that we've improved, as you can see, is the Snip Gallery view. So we've given you the option, now you can view, you know, the original and the rendered image together. You can view just the rendered image, just the original image. So it's kind of up to you how you want to navigate your snips. And you know, the other things that we've added in the Snip Gallery view is, one major thing is that we've standardized the size of all the snips. So that's going to make scrolling a lot nicer. Whereas before, sometimes images would be really tall and kind of make it funky. So we've made that a lot nicer. Like I mentioned before, you're going to see these Open in Snip Web buttons everywhere. So here's an example. I can open up a snip here. And that's nice because, you know, if you want to edit something, just see things in a bigger screen, you still have all your export options over here on the side. So that's really nice. And another thing is that you can delete snips now, individual snips from the gallery. So if I want to just delete some here, and that's going to immediately, you know, update in Snip Web over here. As you can see, those have disappeared. And also just being able to, you know, see the accuracy, you know, kind of more exactly how many total snips you have. So really just making that gallery view, you know, easier to use and, you know, more useful. Yeah, so we're really excited. Those are the, you know, kind of the big things that we're releasing here on the Snipping tool now. So PDF conversion, uploading images, and then just making that gallery view nicer. So we hope you guys like it. We hope you're excited to start using PDF conversion in your Snipping tool. And, you know, as always, we appreciate you. Thank you. And always feel free to reach out to us with feedback, questions. We love to hear it. So thanks, guys. Bye.